Pioneers knock off the Limestone Saints 49-17. They win the Mountain Division, joined by the graduate transfer and Rogan Wells, whose Pioneer offense has really come to life. And Rogan, congratulations, great game. You throw for over 500 yards. It's the fourth highest in school history. And I think even more to that, it's the fact that this offense is continuing to get better. How much more comfortable are you feeling in this offense?
Yes, I mean, coming in here, we're definitely doing a lot more different stuff than what I was used to. But, I mean, we know we're getting better. I mean, we still have things to improve even from this game. I mean, I know we scored 49, but for us and our coaches, I mean, that's just not good enough for us. But, I mean, every week we're learning everything that we did wrong in the game, and, I mean, watching film and everything like that. So I think every week we're getting better.
You know, it was a game in the first half in which I think you had to be very efficient, and very efficient you were, 15 of 19 in that first half, and you seemed to find T.J. Jones. How comfortable are you with him right now out of that backfield?
Yeah, I mean, I love him. He knows how to get open. I mean, but same with our the backup running back, Gamillion. He knows how to get open, and I mean, if up against like an outside linebacker, I'm going to take them probably every time, so they know how to get open.
And you saw the tight end. You saw that T.J. Jones getting some running room after that tight end, that 56-yard touchdown reception. You know, you saw him just run away from his linebacker. Needed in that first half. And then it's in the second half. That offensive line started giving you some time. You're able to take some shots down the field.
Yeah, I mean, well, first half, I was a little jittery back there. I don't know, maybe first time here. I don't know. But I missed some throws. But, yeah, at halftime, KB talked to me and just said just trust it and relax. And so, I mean, second half, I felt like I had plenty of time back there, just sliding in the pocket and doing everything I needed to do.
This running game was going too. You got a rushing touchdown of the game. Well, you counted for, you know, six of the seven rushing touchdowns today, touchdowns total. And again, it was a third down play, and I don't know that it was probably your greatest rushing touchdown of your career, but just kind of take me through the play.
Yeah, I mean, I think we actually called like the wrong play, but I was trying to just stay close to my the pulling tackle, so I would just follow him in the end zone, and then I just cut it back, and one thing led to another. I was stumbling and rumbling, but got in there.
You're accustomed to, you know, winning more things than just the division, obviously a national championship as well. But how special is this for this team from where we started against Newberry to where we are right now to be named divisional champs?
Yeah, I mean, this is great for our team. I think this just builds our confidence. I mean, the Newberry game feels like 2 years ago now. But so I think we're really excited about it. But, I mean, we're still on to the next one. We want to get the conference.
Conference championship maybe looming for this Pioneer team against the incumbent, the Lenoir Rhyne Bears. Rogan, thank you so much. Congratulations on a great game.
Thank you.
Rogan Wells throws for the fifth highest total in passing yards in a game and the seventh time the Pioneers have thrown for over 500 yards in a game. He's the first guy not named Bo Cordell. Back with more of our Pioneer postgame and our wrap after this. Tusculum 49, Limestone 17, as you listen on the Pioneer Sports Network.